Good morning guys, I hope everyone is doing great. So today in this video we'll be talking about GlobalLogic interview experience. This video, the contribution was done by one of our subscriber friend. So in this video we'll be talking about the interview process, like number of rounds that were conducted, experience of the candidate who was interviewed, and what was the package that was offered to the candidate. So here is the mail that we got from our subscriber friend. So GlobalLogic interview experience. Hi Duncan Engineer, your channel helped me a lot in getting through the interviews. The interview process was 3 tech rounds, 1 managerial or HR round. The interview process started on July 9th and ended on July 22. Experience at the time of interview was 6 plus years. Salary offered was 23 plus lakh per annum. Note the they majorly judged me based on my coding skills. Can you share the below interview questions from the tech rounds with the audience? So this is the interview process. Like there were 3 rounds, 3 tech rounds, 1 managerial round. It was for 6 plus years of experience candidate and salary offered was 23 plus lakh per annum. And I hope that is very good package. And if you want to share your interview experience, you feel free to reach us at the email ID that is there in the description. And please do like the video, that definitely motivates everyone. And coming to the questions, here is the first question. So like this was how it was said, like questions related to singleton coding and oral, like both. Maybe the questions were asked theoretical question on singleton, like what is singleton, in which scenarios we'll go with singleton, and apart from that maybe asked to create a singleton class, like how to create a singleton class, how, what is double locking, or how can we break singleton functionality of a class, and how can we prevent singleton functionality of a class. So these all type of questions can be asked here. So if you are having an interview, we brush up on this thing. Then coming to the next question. Questions on internal working of HashMap and concurrent HashMap, both coding and oral. Again, like maybe in and out of the HashMap and concurrent HashMap might have been asked here. Like how do you create, in which scenarios you will go with HashMap and in which scenarios you will go with concurrent HashMap. How does, what is the difference between these two? And how internally they works, how the internal implementation differs of each other. So those kind of questions can be asked here, and might be asked to implement hash code and equals method. Coding means I am assuming that. So that questions can be asked from here on. Basically, if you are preparing, you can prepare on this topic like HashMap and concurrent HashMap. So guys, before getting further into the video, would like to talk about the leading hiring platform of the country that is reliable by an academy, and we would be talking about the current backend openings that are there on this platform. Like let us see what are the top 5 companies that are currently hiring a backend development guy. So the top 5 companies are Razorpay, SuperDaily, FlickText, MoEngage and Animal. And let us see what they are offering and what is the required skill set for them. So coming to the first company, that is Razorpay. So the CTC is 20 to 24 lakhs per annum. The required skills are PHP, Python, Java and CPP. And the second company is SuperDaily, and the CTC that is being offered is 20 lakhs per annum. Required skills are Python, AWS and Big Data. And coming to the third company for backend development, that is FlickText, and it is offering a salary of 15 to 25 lakhs per annum. And the required skills are Java, J2W, Spring Boot, Design Patterns, Kafka, Spark, AWS, Machine Learning is a plus. So, and the fifth company, that is Animal. So it is offering a whopping of 15 to 20 lakhs per annum, and the required skills are Node.js, Python, MySQL, MongoDB, Google Cloud, Firestore, etc. So if you want to get into these companies, you just need to register with Reliable by an academy and take the test, and based on your score you will be shortlisted for the interviews. And once you get shortlisted for the interviews, you will be given a special guidance by Reliable team in cracking the interview. And the entire process of this is only, like the duration of this process is just 1 week. So within 1 week you will be getting the result, whereas compared to other technical like other platforms, other, it is like the time is never ending. You there is no guarantee that when the process would end, but here it is just 1 week. So what are you waiting for? To grab this golden opportunity, visit Reliable by an Academy site, and register for the exam, take the exam and crack your dream job. And if you want to use the coupon code that is there in the description, you will be getting an extra 10% discount on the registration fee. And if at all you are able to crack the interview, the entire registration fee will be given back. So what are you waiting for? Go and register for this test right now and start your dream career. And next question was on difference between immutable and final. So what is the difference between immutable and final? That we have to explain. And next topic is print. It is a coding question. So print non-repeating characters from a string. It's a bit easy. Like don't know exactly like how it was asked, whether using strings or normally. So this is how the question was asked. Print non-repeating characters from a string. So I would say it is an easy only. The next, sort hash map by value. So based on the values, we need to sort the hash map. This is a tricky question. If you are not aware of it, please do practice on this type of questions, because not only here, because you can get this question in any other interview as well. Explain the architecture of JVM. Yeah, if you are having a good experienced candidate, like 5+ years, you can expect this type of questions, like explaining the architecture of JVM. Explain about different memory areas. Obviously, if they are asking about JVM architecture, the next follow-up question would be this, like explaining the memories, like what all different memory areas present there. The next question, what all changes you will make in a class to use it as a key in HashMap? So we need to override equals and hashCode method properly in order to use that class as a key. Basically, yeah, those two things we need to do. Program to remove a character from a string so that it becomes palindrome. Oh, super. This is a good question. So we need to write a program to remove a character so that the given string becomes palindrome. Yeah. So this is a tricky question, to be honest. I don't know about the time complexity that was asked, but a good question here. Lot of questions on multi-threading. So in and out of multi-threading would have been asked here. So that's the reason this was directly shared as a topic. So prepare well on multi-threading as well if you are having an interview with Global Logic. Questions on SQL queries using joins. Okay, super, again good. So it was not discussed like in which round these were asked, but overall the questions were shared. So these are really good like questions. Question on SQL queries, so prepare well on joins as well, like in which scenarios which join you will use. Questions on Hibernate session. So basically like the question would be, what are different sessions available and how do you implement second cache? Oh, session, sorry, okay, session, I thought about cache. Questions on Hibernate session, fine. How do you implement logging in your, how did you implement logging in your application? Microservice, maybe they are using microservice architecture and the question would be like, how do you implement logging when there are different services, n number of services running on n machines? So how would you do that? So there are different ways to achieve that. If you are not aware of it, so please do know that. So next question is, what is API gateway? What issue it resolves? So if you are having an experience on like microservice architecture application, it would be an easy way to answer what is API gateway and what issue it resolves. So, and what maybe a continuing question would be the like, what are different ways we can implement API gateway? Then the next question is, what is circuit breaker? How does it works internally? So again, it is related to microservices only. So if there are chaining operations present, so if at all one operation is failing, so circuit breaker really helps us out there. How have you maintained transaction in your application? Like basically how we can maintain transaction in my microservice architecture applications with microservice architecture. So there are different way, different types, and based upon our requirement we can go with anything. How did you handle authentication in your application? Okay, fine, it's up to, it differs from application to application. So mostly these days microservice applications are following JWT token that thinking or what can be there. How did you handle exceptions in your application? So this was the question. So don't know about it was about microservice architecture or not, but in general how we have used, you can tell. Explain about garbage collection, very generic question, very basic question. Write a code to consume an API. Okay, we can make use of REST template or Fi client. We can consume that. Design an API which will take both XML as well as JSON as input. Yeah, this is a tricky question these days. Even I encountered this. This is a simple thing, but a lot of developers don't know. You can Google it, you will get a nice solution for this. Lot of questions on data structures or data structures. So maybe in and out of data structures, maybe I might have been asked like what all data structures you know and explain them, and might be they have given some scenarios and asked like in this scenario what data structure you would use. Questions on new features in Java 8 and Java 7. Oh, surprisingly Java 7 also has been asked. Usually Java 8, yes, it has become a mandatory interview question now. New features of Java 8. Coming to the next question, using streams, find the sum of even numbers in an array. So interesting question. Using streams, find the second highest salary employee. So from the given list of employees, have to find the second highest. This is a very tricky interview question. I think this is already shared on our channel, so you can go through that. Using streams, find the oldest employee in the organization. So based on the date of joining, we can filter it out. Find the longest palindrome in the given string. It is also easy. Well, I would say tricky, but if you practice good, it is very easy for you. And this is the final question, like input 123, so the output should be 123. Yeah, this is basically how you handle the question, like how the approach towards would be calculated here. It is very easy to print that thing based on the length and based on different things. There are different ways as well. So these were the questions that were shared by our subscriber friend as part of Global Logic interview questions. So this is the mail that we have received. This is a complete mail. Hydrogen engineer. So this we have already gone through this. So these were the questions that what we have received and what we have shared in this video. This I hope this would be helpful for at least few people who wanted to know like what kind of interview process is there at Global Logic and what interview questions they can brush up before taking up an interview with Global Logic. So this is the complete mail, and to that we have replied. Thanks a lot for sharing. So that's it in this video, guys. And if you're on our channel for the first time and if you're wondering like who are we and what we do, so we are basically a bunch of software engineers who attend interviews and share our real-time interview experiences through these videos. Apart from that, we also share our friends or subscriber friends interview experiences as well. And if you want to share yours, you can reach us at the email ID that is there in the description. And if you're wondering what are the company names that are getting printed on your screen, so this we have already shared. You can visit our channel and have a look. And please do subscribe to get Chavlo updates, because there are a lot of interviews that are in the queue. We are not getting enough time, so it is a bit delay to post the interviews. And if you haven't subscribed us, please do subscribe, like, provide the feedback, share it to other technical platforms so that it might be helpful to others as well. So that's it in this video. Thanks for watching, guys.